As you can see, I got my hairs cut, and the reason being is that my wife hates my hair long. And probably for the past 3 weeks, from the moment I would wake up to the moment I went to sleep, she would mention somewhere in a conversation, no matter what we were talking about, we could have been talking about spare ribs or, you know, Pokemon, whatever, because that crap that's going on, and she'd mention my hair. So I broke down today and got a cut. I'd like to share a story today from a viewer who wrote in originally back in early May when my account, actually my Outlook, my email, it crashed. So I had to do a backup. I lost 3 months of emails, caused a big mess. I actually did a video on the fact that I was asking people to write in and resend their stories. So she did just that. She wrote in her story again. But for some reason, when she emailed me yesterday and asked me what the deal was, because it had been so long, I looked at her email in my folder. I have an email folder for stories. Next to her email, it had used written on it. Now, I only do that if I actually read an email for YouTube. I never read her email. It must have just slipped my mind. I must have just put it. And, you know, I make mistakes all the time. And I really appreciate the fact that she wrote me yesterday and let me know that I hadn't done her story, because if she never would have done it, obviously I never would have shared her story. And she was super polite, really nice girl. So her story: I'd like to share my story of recovery from opiates. I'd like to stay anonymous, but I am a 25-year-old female in New York. It all started about 5 years ago when, believe it or not, my previous boss threw a pill my way. I'm not sure why, knowing what he knew they did to a person, that he would ever give that to someone, especially to someone who never asked for it. I was only taking them once in a while to help me work, but then before I knew it, they had control over me. I felt I worked better and was happier while taking these. I found a steady connection who had hundreds of them a month, was getting a month's supply once a month. In parentheses, also now, I will never understand why anyone would need to be prescribed 300 plus 10 milligram hydrocodones a month, end parentheses. But needless to say, there was a ton available to me to buy. I also think being able to have a connection like this, where I would only buy once a month, made me more in denial of me having a problem, because I wasn't searching for more pills each day or week. I just did my once a month pickup. You know what? That's a really, really good point. And I'm going to make note of that for a future video. That's really good. It started at just 40 a month, then progressed to 80 a month, but then it turned to buying about 200 plus a month. I was spending all of my money, but I didn't care. I let bills go. I let everything go. My car got repossessed at one point, which never would have happened if it weren't for this. I would calculate my pay and be left with scraps after I factored in how much money I needed for pills. Then I found myself having to struggle the last couple days till my refill. One day, I decided it was enough and I couldn't do it anymore. I wanted to quit for myself, not be forced to quit because I didn't have the money or supply or whatever it might be. I also wanted to be able to save up to buy a house. I knew that would never happen if I continued how I was going. My life and activities revolved around how many pills I had left and when my refill was. So I made a doctor's appointment under false pretenses. In parentheses, I couldn't bear to tell a receptionist over the phone why I needed an appointment, or I'd break down on the phone. End parentheses. Till I got into the room with the doctor and just broke down. I couldn't stop crying. Saying it out loud was a huge deal to me, mostly because I never thought I had a problem, because I was well functioning. My life was going great, have a great job, etc. So to say I'm addicted to pills was extremely emotional and difficult. Also, no one knew I was taking these. Definitely a secret. To this day, I don't think anyone would believe me if I told them. It was so well hidden, and I appeared so normal, I told myself I didn't have a problem. I thought I was taking them responsibly. I thought at least I'm not on heroin or anything. Just little lies to myself, I guess, about the severity of my unrecognized problem. So I was then put on Suboxone. I found myself also abusing those and taking more than prescribed. And it just felt like a new addiction, honestly. Due to that and some insurance issues, I decided I was also done with those and jumped off. It was one of the hardest things ever. I was freezing cold for days, depressed, irritable, couldn't eat or drink, couldn't sleep. My back and legs were in so much pain, I felt like I got hit by a truck. I got suicidal thinking, I cannot go on like this, and what have I done to myself? Today is day 13, completely clean. Now, she is actually now over 2 months clean, because we were talking about it yesterday. So during this email, she said, today is day 13, completely clean, and I feel so much better. Well, I finally started feeling better about 2 days ago, so that would have been day 11. I'm still lacking a little energy, but I know it's coming soon, just like everything else has. I'm successful at work still, even without having the pills, which is pretty amazing. I used to think I'd be failing miserably if I didn't have them and wouldn't be able to be successful at anything. You know, that's part of the lie. That's the lie in the brain and the mind and that's telling you that you need this stuff just to be able to be social, interact, and be good at anything. I just wanted to share because I know how hopeless it feels when you're going through this and you can't see an end in sight. But push through. It's so worth it. It's so rewarding to say, quote, I pushed through this hell and I made it, end quote. I feel genuinely happy right now, and I know it's only going to get better. Your videos are extremely helpful. I loved hearing all the different stories and being able to see that this can grab a hold of you, anyone, and I'm not alone in this fight. Thank you. Great email. Definitely interesting because, you know, she hit on the fact that she only picked up once a month. So, unlike someone like myself, when I was active, I was searching every single day. I was, you know, doing whatever I had to do in order to pick up that day if I had no pills. And towards the end, the last, I'd say about maybe 6 months, every day was a mission to find more. I never had really a stash of an enormous amount of pills. Sometimes I would have 1 day's worth extra, and that was a big deal. But most of the time I was scheming and trying to figure out ways that I was able to, you know, not get sick for that day. The other thing she hits on, which is which is pretty cool, and I was just about to say it, and then, oh, the successful at work thing. So many people, including myself, when you take on withdrawal, you start to think about after withdrawal, what life is going to be like when you're actually clean. And if you use for a prolonged period of time, you actually start to believe that you need pills or opiates in general just to be able to function, to be able to be social, to be able to laugh, be funny, dance. I mean, there's a million different things, but the reason you feel that way is that you needed the pills when you were addicted in order to function. So you automatically, you think even when you're off of them, you still need them to function. And that's the furthest thing from the truth. When you get clean and your brain starts to heal and you start to genuinely be happy like she is, you start to realize that you never needed any of this crap to begin with. You will laugh a real laugh. You'll dance. You'll enjoy music. You'll get goosebumps. You'll be in love. You'll be able to have sex. I mean, it's just, you're back to a natural state where your body was supposed to be, your mind is healthy, and everything is going to start feeling fantastic. All right? So, if you'd like to share your story, you can email me at ryan@compsupport.com. In the subject line, put YouTube story and my story. Let me know if you want to use your first or last name or stay anonymous. Continue watching, leave some comments, and check out freefromhell.com too. All right? So, I'll see you guys here tomorrow. Take care.